Fibromyalgia is diagnosed when the person has widespread pain for more than 3 months and another disease cannot explain this pain. In this video, I will explain what do we mean by widespread pain. What are other diseases that could look like fibromyalgia? Is there a mild form of fibromyalgia? Are there other symptoms or only pain? Are there signs in the body that could suggest fibromyalgia? Can fibromyalgia fluctuate, like some days I feel better and for others I am in much pain? Is there any blood test or image of the brain that can show if I have fibromyalgia or not? So let's talk about the diagnosis of fibromyalgia today. Before I continue, let me explain that this video is not intended to provide medical advice. It is for educational purposes only. If you have a medical condition that requires treatment, please talk to your doctor to get a treatment plan for you. And if there is any emergency, please go to the nearest emergency department or call an ambulance. First, I want to ensure that everyone understands that the pain from fibromyalgia is real. You may have been told that your pain is in your head and you heard doctors saying you were inventing or imagining this pain. I'm sorry if this happened to you. The problem is that we don't learn about chronic pain in medical school and what causes fibromyalgia. The person with fibromyalgia looks normal and they have nothing to show that they have fibromyalgia except what they feel. Many people with fibromyalgia are not believed, even by their relatives and friends. They feel that they need to convince everyone that they are in real pain, which is very frustrating. When they have an acute pain episode, they don't know if that is a flare-up of the fibromyalgia or if they are having an injury or a disease causing pain. When they seek medical care, they are told that pain is explained by their fibromyalgia. So it isn't very encouraging. Our healthcare system is not prepared to help people with fibromyalgia. And that's very sad. Fibromyalgia is a malfunction of the pain system. I explained that in another video. You may watch it here. Basically, we have a pain system like an alarm system of a house. When the alarm system malfunctions, it will go off constantly and the volume will be very high. So having fibromyalgia is like living in a house where the alarm system is going off all the time. It is very loud and you call the fire truck, police, paramedics. They come and tell you that your house is not in danger, that you must be imagining these things. Nobody can hear the noise, only you. Then you also start getting depressed, anxious, and having sleep problems. I also have another video in which I answer a question that someone posted on the previous video. Why do some people have fibromyalgia and others don't? There are predisposing factors in life, like adverse childhood experiences. When a child has emotional stressors, some centers in the brain do not develop properly. So when this person becomes an adult and has a painful or a stressful event like a car crash, surgery, an acute pain, they cannot stop the danger signals in their brain. And they keep feeling that pain for months, years, or decades. Back to our original question. How is fibromyalgia diagnosed? The person needs to have widespread pain, which means pain on the right and left side of the body, front and back, above and below the waist, and in the trunk. This pain has to last for at least 3 months. The person may also have good days and bad days, but the pain has to be present every day or constant pain. The pain may be described as tiring, heavy, aching, pressure, numbness, soreness, deep, and tingling. Another common symptom includes fatigue. It is a kind of fatigue that does not get better with rest. They also have mood problems like depression, anxiety, and sleep problems. It is essential to exclude other causes of this pain. So when we order blood tests or imaging studies, we think of another problem that could be causing the symptoms like anemia, hypothyroidism, lupus, vitamin B12 deficiency, diabetes, and liver or kidney failure. Myofascial pain is sometimes confused with fibromyalgia and they can co-occur. Do you like this video so far? So give a thumbs up here and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Myofascial pain is regional pain affecting the muscles of one part of the body. Any muscle can be affected by myofascial pain, but the pain is localized to a region and palpation of the muscle is painful and reproduces the patient's symptoms. Sometimes the pain from myofascial pain radiates to the arms or legs. A poor posture or overuse of that muscle may cause myofascial pain. Myofascial pain that is not treated properly can sensitize the pain system, and then the person will start having mild symptoms of fibromyalgia. I see many patients who are showing some signs of fibromyalgia. They have a mild form of fibromyalgia. We need to help them before they develop more symptoms of fibromyalgia. When we examine the patient with fibromyalgia, we do not find an injury or inflammation that explain the symptoms in the periphery, but we may find signs of central sensitization, which includes pain when we touch the skin. This is called allodynia. We may also find hyperalgesia, which is a lot of pain when we do a stimulation with a tiny painful stimulus. This means that their pain system is sensitized and malfunctioning. But not everyone with fibromyalgia will have allodynia or hyperalgesia. In the beginning, the mild forms, they don't have the symptoms. However, in the more severe cases, they may have a paradoxical response in which they do not feel when we touch them with a light stroke in the skin. This is called hypoesthesia, and they do not feel pain in the skin, and we call this hypoalgesia. These sensory abnormalities are not confined to one nerve distribution or a nerve root distribution, so we can't explain them by a neuropathic pain. The brain is responsible for these altered sensations. So again, we need to look at abnormal neurological connections in the brain, because these sensations and pain are generated in the brain. The person may feel good days and bad days, and that is because the brain can modulate and block sensations like pain. Unfortunately, there are no brain images that we can do today to diagnose if a person has fibromyalgia or not. Maybe in the future this will be possible. So, in summary, the diagnosis of fibromyalgia is based on clinical symptoms, the physical examination, and exclusion of other conditions that could mimic the symptoms of fibromyalgia. Send this video to someone that needs to hear this message. There is a share button here. And here are other videos from my channel that you can watch. See you next time. Goodbye.